Hey there, folks. Luke here with the Outdoor Gear Review. I hope you're all doing well. Today for this episode, we're doing some camping. We're doing some stealth camping. So we have to be very, very quiet. Not getting caught is the name of this game. Now, of course, we'll talk about stealth camping a little bit more coming up. But right now, let's talk about this trip. It is going to be an epic one. We are far from home. We just drove about 2 hours so I can be dropped off. No vehicle. I'm out on my own. Right now we're on an old road. I cannot say where. But here in a couple hours, I will be getting off this road. We'll have to do some navigation. We have to go off trail. We have to get off the roads and do a little bushwhacking. But we have about 25 miles to cover so that we can be picked up tomorrow. Now, the question becomes, can we get picked up tomorrow? We have a winter storm coming in tonight. It's supposedly gonna start before midnight. Snow possibly transitioning over to sleet, maybe freezing rain. We shall see. Nobody seems to know. So my guess is that we could wake up in the morning, there may be snow flying. We may wake up in the morning and it's not doing anything. It may be raining. I don't know. Either way, we have 25 miles to hike in it. So we're going to get done as much as we can tonight. Now, one cool element to this trip is that if the weather gets bad, the roads will be closed. And if the roads are closed, we will be on them. How exciting is that? Now you may be wondering, where is Luke? This is an undisclosable location. I cannot say. That is part of the game when you go stealth camping. So with all that being said, my main goal is to be at the meeting point tomorrow, which is 25 miles away. Will that be possible? Will I be slowed down because of the storm? Will there be a storm? Will my ride even be able to make it? I might have to stay out here for multiple nights. We shall see. This is a true adventure. Now, for the people that don't know, stealth camping is also known as wild camping, and it's practiced all around the world. Essentially, it is the art of camping in unconventional, unestablished sites or areas. It can be illegal or legal. In most cases, it is legal. There are a number of rules to follow, which we will cover as we go along on this trip. Two of the most important rules, and really there are many important rules, but two of the biggest. One, leave no trace. Two, don't get caught. When you're stealth camping, your goal is to be out and about without anybody knowing that you're there. I do want to say that if you're going to go out and do some stealth camping yourself, some wild camping, do not break the law. Very, very important. A lot of people will, and hey, that's fine if that's what you want to do. Now I, for this trip, am not breaking the law for many reasons. I've researched this very, very carefully, so I know exactly where I'm going. I know the lands that I'm going to cover, and of course I could tell you more if I could disclose where I was. This must be the calm before the storm, I suppose. It's a beautiful day. It's probably 45 degrees or so. Winds are about 9 miles an hour. Feels pretty darn awesome. It is already pretty late in the day, and I did this intentionally. A lot of the land that I have to cover is right next to roads, or in some cases, on roads. So some of this traveling I'm gonna have to do at nighttime. Yes, even though it's not illegal what I'm doing, I still don't want to be caught. That's kind of the fun in it, for me anyway. Most people, when they go stealth camping, they're not going out and doing stealth adventures like I am. They're riding on their bikes, picking a place just to camp out on the side of the road, unseen, unknown, or they're hiking around doing a short little trip, so on and so forth. I've decided to take this to the next level. Right up here is a road. We'll have to get away from it, but I'll show it to you real quickly. Might be able to see it right there. And actually there's a car coming, so let's keep on going. We have about 3 hours, a little bit less than that, of light left. And we have about 10 miles to go. Tomorrow, if everything goes to plan, we have about 15 miles. Yeah. I absolutely love adventures, and this is definitely a true adventure. I believe I said and mentioned in the last overnight trip that it was going to be a good one, and hopefully it will be. We've got some pretty cool gear with us today. Some of it's new, some of it's very old, very inexpensive, but still great. We've also got some good food. And when I say we, I'm talking about you and I, because you guys are coming with me. You are my brothers and sisters in crime. Not that we're committing any crimes, of course. Just a saying, right? Throughout this video, I will be giving you all some tips when it comes to stealth camping, wild camping. Of course, if you have your own, please post them down below, share them with everybody else. Also, if you want to discuss the rights and wrongs, your opinion of stealth camping, please feel free to. Do it, be respectful to each other, that's all that I ask. Some people are fine with it, some people are not. I see it both ways. Now, when we started, I gave you guys two rules. Leave no trace. Don't get caught. Now it's time to talk about a few more. Again, these are very, very basic and also very important. When I say leave no trace, that also means no fire. Someone who is truly stealth camping does not have a fire. They will also use little to no light once the sun goes down. Now, will we have to use a light tonight? More than likely, some. But I'm prepared for that. I'll show you what I mean later on. Lots of coyote poop out here. But the last rule for right now, we'll keep hitting on others later, is again, very, very simple. You do not set up camp until it's getting dark. You do it right at that point where there's just a little bit of light left and you can see what you're doing. Then it gets dark. You don't wait until it's so dark that you have to use a flashlight to set up. Again, no light. You also don't want to set up too early so that other people may see you. You have to remain undiscovered. As it stands now, I have about 4 miles to go before I get off the trail and start doing some bushwhacking. Based on the location of the sun, I better get moving. Let's go. I thought I heard voices there for a second. I'm gonna find a place to chill here just for a minute. Make sure there aren't people coming up or coming behind us. Let's see where I can get off the trail for a moment. Okay, well, it's been a couple of minutes. I've been sitting here and I haven't heard anything at all. So maybe it was my imagination. Maybe we are still pretty close to that road. I definitely hear cars, so who knows what I heard. But I think we're all right for now. Let's keep on going. Now for this adventure, I am using water bottles instead of a hydration bladder, and the reasoning is pretty simple. I don't want to mess with a hydration bladder. I don't want to have to pull it out. I don't want to have to fill it up. I don't want to have to dry it off. I don't want to have to try to get it back inside of my full pack. I want the bottles. I want to fill them up when I come to a stream and deal with it later. Look at all this bark coming off of this tree. Now phase one of this section is complete. We are now merging with another road. As you can see right there, the road does split, as you can see. So far everything is going according to plan. I have paper maps if I need them. I have my GPS if I need it. I also have the maps inside of my head. We're in pretty good shape. We have about 1 mile to go before we get off this road. We definitely have some mountains to cover. It'll be interesting to see just how thick the forest is going to be, too. Once we get off this road, being quiet will be key. That is one aspect to stealth camping for sure. All right, my friends. We are now off trail. We need to get away from that road. Okay. Beautiful place. Let me show you real quick. Now, of course, I cannot just walk out in the middle of this. I have to skirt it. You have to go to the places where you're not going to be noticed and where other people are not going to go. It may add time, it may add effort, but that's how the game is played. Okay. Whew, man, I am warm now. Warm and chilly all at the same time. I'm gonna dry off for just a minute before I keep on going. Time is definitely of the essence. Sunset is coming soon. Whew, let's go. This is definitely about to get very, very thick. I may have to put the camera up just to make it through this. This is a jungle. Very thick indeed. Definitely slow going right now, but that's how it goes sometimes. I see a landmark up here. I know this mountain, so I need to basically keep my direction towards that mountain so I can zigzag some, and that's fine as long as I keep heading towards that mountain. I just came across a pretty large sized bone here. Wonder what's from. Deer, maybe? Who knows? Now, since this is going to be so slow going, I'm going to need both of my hands, so the camera's going up. I'll bring you guys back when I get out of this mess. The next section will begin when I make it down to the creek. All right, guys. This has been very slow going. I put the camera up. Basically, I'm just pushing through the brush. Let me give you a 360 so you guys can see what I'm working with here. It is pure jungle right now, but we are getting very, very close to where we need to be. Maybe another half mile or so. So we should be getting done with this right around dark. So everything's going according to plan. Now, of course, I have to say, everybody, do not do this unless you know what you're doing. Do not do this if you're not good with navigation. Whew. This is so thick, you could easily get lost. I better go. All right, I'll bring you guys back in a little bit. All right. We have made it to the creek. Very slow going. This is very, very thick, but I believe I'm working up my way to a little bit of an opening. Less of this jungle, more just woods. So, doing good. All right. Well, my opening has failed just a little bit. It was a clearing for about 5 minutes. And that is just fine. We're making good progress. We still have plenty of light left. Also, I'm going slow enough not to really sweat. That is important, especially with how cold it will be later tonight. Sweating is just fine if you're gonna go home and take a hot shower. It's not good if you're out trying to survive. Okay. All right. We are finally out of that mess. Woo! My goodness. That was incredibly thick. the final push was intense. We went from the ridge down into the valley. We crossed the creeks, but then it shot back uphill a little bit and it was super, super thick. And that's all right. I'm gonna take a minute here just to cool off. I'm super hot, very sweaty. I need some water. We'll keep on going. Whew. All right, as you can see here, it's starting to get pretty dark and we are right next to that road. So now being stealthy is key. As you can see here, I got my red light on. I got my hand ready just to block it if I need to, just like that. Well, this is a great example of how you hope for the best, prepare for the worst, because we are a couple of miles away from where we need to be for the night. And we're gonna have to be basically going alongside of this road for a while. So we're definitely gonna have to be stealthy. We definitely don't want to draw any attention to us. So this will be interesting. This has been so much fun, I have to say. A true adventure. When it comes to a trip like this, you really have to plan for everything. And I definitely have been planning. Now the temperatures definitely have been dropping. See my breath now. It's probably about 35 degrees, so it's not terribly cold. Hopefully here in a little bit, I'll be able to actually show you guys something. It's gonna be pretty dark, pretty slow going right now. We're still in the woods, still pretty thick. I'd release a big howl right now if it wouldn't break every single rule when it comes to stealth camping. We are high above the city now. So finally, my friends, I'm in a position to talk. We got across the bridge. Woohoo! That was a big chore. There was a lot of traffic. This entire section right here has been almost stressful, trying to avoid all the traffic. Ducking behind trees, behind bushes. I wish I could have been recording it, but it's night, no light. I did have my light on there just for a second so you guys can see the trail. I'm hiking with my blue light right now, but I'm using the red one. Let's switch over. Make sure there's no cars coming. I'll show you. White, red, green, and blue. Here in just a little bit, we'll be ready to make camp. So not much further. Just got to get to the top of this mountain here. Woohoo! Definitely having to keep an eye on my GPS, make sure I'm headed in the right direction. Oh, light off. Car coming. So you guys could definitely see what I'm working with here. Lots and lots of people. Man, this is awesome. All right, well, I'm coming up the mountain. And let me tell you guys, it smells so freaking bad. I must have startled a skunk at some point because this is freshly sprayed. I'm not sprayed, but he's definitely sprayed around here somewhere. Whew, it's kind of funny. Kind of good, kind of bad. It's kind of messed up, isn't it? That right there is our road across. A little bit further and we will be done. Here comes another car. All right, guys, we've made it to the top of this mountain here, and this is definitely where we're gonna camp out tonight. Before I get comfortable, I need to scout around and make sure there's no people around. So I'm gonna do that now, and once the coast is clear, we'll start cooking, because I am starving. I will also show you the incredible view up here. Come morning, it's gonna be spectacular.
Yeah. The North Star, and we also have an airplane right there. car driving by, but also the city lights.
All right, everybody, the coast is clear. We're in good shape for the night. It is time to get our stove out and time to start cooking. Tonight I am using these Fjallraven bags. This is my food bag here. This is my fire kit and stove. We are using solid fuel, and we are using the Vargo titanium stove, but just the plate. For this purpose, it should work pretty darn well. Push it into the ground. Tonight's meal is a real termat, and this is some sort of beef dish. Not entirely sure what it is, but I'm sure it is gonna be good. Okay. I tell you, I am ready to eat. I am absolutely famished. I'm also just absolutely worn out. It has been a heck of a day, heck of a trip. Whew, I am super tired. Once we eat, I'm just gonna turn in. And actually, I'm almost too tired, really, to talk. That bushwhacking really wore me out. That was really hard going. But our food should be ready here in just a minute. We are now under a winter weather advisory for snow and freezing rain and sleet. From what I read, it's gonna start around 10 o'clock in the morning. So that will definitely be interesting. The view up here is spectacular. Sadly, the camera's not gonna pick it up because it's kind of wooded, but I can see through the trees here. And I could just see for literally 100 miles. Nothing but city lights, city way off. There's another city over there and another one over here. It's pretty dang nice. Temperatures have definitely dropped. It's definitely getting cold. Our water is almost ready. So that's pretty nice. Oh, man. Absolutely spectacular, everybody. Okay. We have our meal here. Oh, it feels so good. It's nice and warm. Ah, the difference a hot meal can make. I did put more water in this than what they call for because I really want something, you know, with some broth in it. Especially considering just how freaking cold it is. Temperatures are in the 20s right now. Fantastic. Just what I needed. With this stove here, the Vargo, I still don't like it. Those legs that hold your pot, that support your pot, are horrible. Some are flimsy, some are really stiff. You need them to be stiff so that if your pot has a curved bottom on it, it doesn't fall over. Of course, that's what testing gear out, that's what the Outdoor Gear Review is all about there. So yeah, I'm definitely sticking with my review of that. Awful product. Poorly thought out. That's starting to thicken up pretty darn good. Let's go ahead and try a bite. Guys, that is so freaking awesome. My story for the night's pretty funny. I was 18 years old, and it was some crappy job that I had working third shift. And so I became friends with this guy who worked there. And he said that he was really into camping and stuff and had all this gear. So he convinced me to go camping with him. And we ended up working that day and worked late into the night. And he still wanted to go, and he said he had all the gear. So, man, we walk out in the parking lot. We take off. We drive for about an hour and a half. Actually, it was out towards the Linville Gorge, if any of you know where that's at. We've been out there a couple of times. So we cruise around out there for a pretty long time. That's a slow-going road. It's pretty rough. And we can't find any place to camp. And I thought, you know, he made it sound like he had been there. He knows where he's going and all this good stuff. So we decided just to pull over. We're going to just camp on the side of the road. So that's exactly what we did. Well, he opens up his toolbox where he thought he put all of his gear. And it turns out that he didn't. All he brought was 2 sleeping bags. That's the only 2 things that he actually put in the toolbox. And he had forgotten everything else. So here we are. We're about an hour and a half away from home. It's probably about 12:30 in the morning. And we were having a camp out on the side of the road with just a sleeping bag. And of course, it's raining. So we ended up having to grab a piece of plastic out of the back of his truck. Thankfully, he had that. And we ended up just rolling ourselves up in that and slept there and listened to the rain come down on that plastic all night long. It was somewhat miserable, I have to be honest. It was cold, but still, I had a blast. I really did love it. There's very few trips that I haven't loved or enjoyed. You know, there's usually something about each trip that I enjoy. And you can say that's roughing it, I guess, with just a sleeping bag and a piece of plastic. But it did the trick. Memorable. That's what all these adventures are about. They're about memories. It's about feeling comfortable. It really is. Comfortable with yourself. Comfortable with the environment. With the world that surrounds you. At times, it means feeling comfortable with somebody else. Every trip, I feel like I learned something. I gained something. So, and this trip has been no different. It's been a doozy so far. I wish you guys could have seen everything that we've gone through just to get here. We had to run down that road and just hiding from cars, being all stealthy. That is the name of the game. Let's go ahead and eat. Oh, even though I have to admit that this bag full of warm food between my legs feels pretty darn good. Gosh, I think I'll just drink right out of the bag. Oh, yeah. We got started with this trip around 3:30, something like that. And now it's after 10 o'clock at night. And I've been running and gunning the entire time. It's been wide open, full blast, and it has been absolutely worth it. This meal is fantastic. Good idea to add some extra water to that, make it brothy. That'll work a little bit better. That way you guys can see me and I'm not blinded at the same time. If I wasn't so tired, I'd answer your guys' questions, but I'm beat. I don't have it in me. After we finish eating here, I'm gonna get my bivy out, blow up the sleeping pad, and go to sleep. I'm gonna sleep like a rock. I know that for sure. I'll be able to sleep here and just stare up at the stars all night long. That sounds pretty good, don't it? I'm gonna just kick back, I'm gonna relax, stare at the city lights, stare at the stars, enjoy my meal. I'll bring it back before I go to bed. We've got a long way to go tomorrow with some very questionable conditions. We shall see. You know, everybody, in these videos, I often talk about my life and everything that I'm going through, what's going on. I would love to hear from you all. What is going on in your lives? I'm interested, just like with a friend. I want to know what's going on in your lives. If you guys feel like sharing, post in the comment box down below. Good, bad, doesn't matter, whatever you feel like sharing. Time to enjoy this a little bit more. So here are my sleeping arrangements. Bivy, nice and simple to put down, nice and simple to pick up. That's key when you're stealth camping. I've got my quilt here. Got some hand warmers in there, just warming it up for me, can't wait. And I got my Therm-a-Rest pad. Should be nice and comfortable tonight. So my friends, our adventure has come to an end for this evening. It is time to get some shut-eye and see what the morning has in store for us. I have the feeling it's going to be quite the adventure. I'll bring you guys back when I can. Hey there, guys. Good morning. It is about 7 o'clock, and it is currently dropping some freezing rain and some sleet. So you could say this is going according to plan. I prefer snow, but that's all right. But not a bad start. Pretty good night. Slept really good. I was super tired. Slept great. Very warm right now. I don't know if last night was a meteor shower or what, but I saw some just absolutely awesome shooting stars. That's very, very cool. But my plan is just to kick back for a while, I could tell that the road is not closed yet, and I prefer if it's closed before I left. So that's what we're kind of waiting on. So I'm gonna stay inside the bivvy here for at least another hour, and then go from there. Pretty awesome. I'll bring you guys back and show you all around once it lightens up just a little bit. It's still pretty dark. All right. This is my view from the bivvy. Still can't see a whole lot, but it's definitely starting to lighten up. We've camped out underneath this tree. Here we have my poncho, my pack, and all my gear is underneath this. You might be able to see the ice and stuff on this here.
But, it is about 8 o'clock now, and I'm still laying on the ground, and I think I'm going to stay for a while longer. Very comfortable indeed. I'm enjoying just listening to the rain come down. And it really is more of a freezing rain than even a sleet. I am kind of getting ready for a cup of coffee, though. That will be nice. Ooh.
Well, my friends, we finally got out of our bivvy, and the sleet is really coming down right now. The ground's actually starting to get a little bit white. That might make the rest of this trip pretty darn slow. We shall see. But let me go ahead and show you all around. That is where I slept last night. Absolutely comfortable. And I slept underneath this tree. Beautiful place to camp out, as you can see here. Absolutely gorgeous. My main focus right now is to break down camp, get some coffee in me. I tell you, I'm not super hungry, but I will have a snack. And then I'm gonna start walking. I've got 15 more miles to go today. And with these conditions, it may take a while. Definitely the ground is getting icy. I've been wearing this poncho for a while and it is absolutely coated in ice. Still sleeting away, pretty darn cold. At least we're gonna have some hot coffee in a minute. Gonna have a snack. I just got word that the schools in the county are closing here. So that may be a little bit of foreshadowing of what we can expect as we hike out of here. That should make our trip home interesting. What do you think? Man, I slept really, really good last night. I was so incredibly tired. I just lay there for a while and I just stared up at the stars and they were amazing. I saw one shooting star that was incredibly bright and it just went whoosh all the way across. That was awesome. Now I also heard some other things that I can't quite explain. It sounded like somebody was shooting a potato gun. You know, I mean, if anybody's ever shot a potato gun, or you could look it up on YouTube, I guess, but it sounds like someone was shooting a potato gun. It was like whoosh. I don't know. It's interesting. Ooh, that coffee is strong this morning. This poncho that I'm using is a Frog Togs poncho. And, you know, the material is interesting. When I get home, I'll have to look into it and see what exactly it is. It looks a little odd, but so far, it's keeping me nice and dry, so that's all right. Now, yesterday, we started going over some rules, I guess you could say, for stealth camping. And now, since we have another moment, a free moment, let's go over some more. Now, one rule that we definitely broke last night was that we set up camp after dark. It's always best to do that right as it's getting dark, so that way you don't have to use a flashlight. But we are in a pretty secure location, away from anybody that could see us. And we'll actually come to that in just in a minute, because that's important. But yeah, we did break our own rules, but it was okay. We were still smart about it. Now, like I said, we were above everybody else. That's the next thing. When you stealth camp, do your best to be above the roads. That's very important. That way, you can see down, but people can't see up and see you. So where I'm at, I'm on top of a knoll, and the road is way down off of this hill. So there's no way for them to see me up here. So just have to pick your locations very, very wisely. Now, you all saw with my camp setup, I just used a bivy, very, very simple. And that's very important when it comes to stealth camping. You want to be able to set up your camp very quickly, and you want to break it down very quickly. If you're discovered, you need to be able to pack it up and take off. I would never bring a tent with poles for stealth camping, personally. Now, yesterday we did talk about the legality of this. Do not ever camp on property that says private property, or it says no trespassing, something like that. That means stay off. They will definitely press charges. Now, if you're at a place where you don't see any of those signs, you don't see any fences, go for it. And, you know, if you get stopped, you be calm, you be nice, and just be like, hey, I didn't know. When you're out stealth camping, leave the ego at home. You're going out to have a good time. You're not going to go out and try to push somebody else's buttons, especially if you're camping on somebody else's property. My next tip is, if you can, ask someone to camp on their property. It's always better to ask than not to ask. But you may not be in a situation where you know who the owner of the property is, but if you do, if there's just one little house and one, you know, big chunk of land right next to this road, ask them. It's always better to ask. My next tip is leave your gun at home. If you're gonna go stealth camping, if you're gonna be on questionable property, do not bring your gun. If you get caught trespassing with a gun as well, you could be in a lot of trouble. Next tip, final tip for right now, don't dress in all camo. Yes, the name of the game is stealth camping, but if someone catches you out hiking the roads, going in some field, on some mountain, whatever, you don't want to be dressed like a commando. I mean, that's going to do nothing but just weird people out. So, yeah, wear darker colors. Don't bring your yellow tint. I mean, all pretty common sense stuff. But you don't have to go to such an extreme that makes you suspicious to others. So, well, I just finished with my coffee, and I'm going to heat up a little bit more water here, just because this water is freezing cold. Having some warm water to drink this morning to brush my teeth with is going to be pretty nice. Man, this stove is so sketchy. The only reason I brought it along was because I wanted to test it out with solid fuel. I will do an update video on this thing. What a shame. Camp is all broken down. We're pretty much ready to go. After I finish eating here, drinking a little bit more water. I was pretty dehydrated yesterday. Yesterday was hard work. Oh yeah, that is nice. Pretty much ready to pack up and get out of here. I have some hand warmers here, which I'm just gonna shove in my pockets. Eventually, I may put them in my gloves. It's pretty darn cold, it's pretty darn wet. Just having that source of heat on your body and your pockets makes a world of difference. I'm gonna finish up this water and get super hydrated. Oh, that is fantastic, having that nice warm water on such a cold morning. Whew, that is great. I'm gonna finish this water, get hydrated, pack everything up, switch to the GoPro. It's too wet for these cameras. And we'll get out of here. 15 miles to go, baby.
Again, time to do a little bit of warming up by going uphill. My face is absolutely frozen. I need to get my mask on.
This section has been pretty darn nice, namely because we got to the top of the hill that warmed me up. Now we're going back down. I feel great. It is beautiful. It is slick. This is a true adventure. Let me tell you what, we have been all over the place. I'm walking alongside of a road here, and traffic is definitely starting to dwindle down. Probably because it's getting very, very slick. Since the road is not closed, we're just walking alongside of it, and that was my plan B for this trip. I needed to make sure that there was a trail that follows this road. Like I said before, I did a lot, and I mean a lot of planning for this trip. And if you're gonna go out and do a trip like I did, like I am, you have to do a lot of planning too. Everything is iced up. The tripod is fully iced. The rocks, the trees, the leaves, myself, everything is iced. This is one beautiful spot. There's a wall over here that's just nothing but rock. Very cool indeed. The trail is getting very, very slick. The ice is really starting to build up. Definitely having to go very slow. That's a good thing too, because I'm not overheating, I'm not sweating. I bet those are some old graves right there. I was gonna stop for lunch, but it's just raining too hard, freezing rain of course, so I'm just gonna keep on going. I'll eat when I'm done. I'd say we're about halfway through, making pretty good progress. Well, the good news is that I have completed the 15 miles. It's pretty late in the afternoon. The sun's probably gonna be going down here fairly soon. I'm just camped out underneath this pine tree that's given me some pretty good shelter. And I'm waiting on my ride, which should be pulling over there sometime soon. This is pretty busy through here. There's a couple of houses over there, so I'm gonna be pretty quiet. I'm just gonna sit here, relax, cool off a little bit. Well, my friends, my ride has arrived. So it is time to go home.
Well, my friends, I just happened to have found the most beautiful woman I have ever seen. Oh my gosh. I am one lucky guy for multiple reasons. Not only do I have a wonderful wife who will drive hours to drop me off and then drive hours to pick me up, but I've been out on a crazy, awesome overnight stealth experience that was truly a lot of fun. There was a lot of things that I saw and got to experience that definitely will make for good memories.
My friends, I want to thank you all so very much for watching this episode of the Outdoor Gear Review. Please make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. I will see you guys around. Make sure to pay attention and watch out for the after the camp. We'll talk about the gear, we'll talk about the trip, all that good stuff. Strength and honor. Be well.